I'm back again with another tutorial. This time we'll be checking out the Vernier spectrophotometer. You're gonna need a few things, so get prepared. I don't like waiting around. Right. Let's get started. Open Logger Pro. See how the screen changes as it recognizes the instrument. Check out the spec as well. Notice it's lit up. Perfect. Now, the spec is no good if it's not calibrated with your blank, so pay attention. In this case, your blank will be a cuvette of DI water. Check out the different surfaces of the cuvette. Make sure to put it in with the smooth side facing the light bulb icon on the spec. If you screw this up, you'll get dodgy results. Give your blank cuvette a rub down to remove greasy fingerprints and dust from the smooth surfaces and place it in the spec. On Logger Pro, select Experiment, Calibrate, Spectrophotometer. Now you gotta wait for it to warm up for a minute. When it's done, press Calibrate now and in a few seconds press OK. Now you'll need to find a suitable wavelength for your experiment. You can't just choose one willy-nilly, that's not gonna work. Place a cuvette with your highest concentration standard in the spec and press Collect. Now you get this funky graph showing the absorbance of your sample at different wavelengths. See? This one absorbs most in the blue-green area of the spectrum. Auto-scale that bad boy and press Stop. It's a good idea to print a copy and stick it in your notebook. Now, you want to choose the wavelength of highest absorbance, which is shown by the arrow. Press the Configure Spectrophotometer button, find and click on Absorbance versus Concentration and choose the best wavelength on the right. 407 nanometers looks good in this case. You should also fill in the boxes with the correct concentration units and stuff so your graph looks right. Done. You can save your data or discard it. Whatever works for you. Nice. Now you're ready to roll. Check out these areas of the screen, they're important, especially the Keep button. Now press Collect and notice the Keep button is lit up. Give it a push and type in the concentration of standard you have in the spec. It should still be your highest one. Okay. Notice that the point on the graph moves accordingly. Don't press Stop, you're not done yet. Now remove that standard and replace it with the next one in line. Make sure to wipe it down before putting it in the spec. Press Keep and enter the concentration. Check it out, it should be lower in absorbance than your last sample. Excellent. Go on down the line until you've entered all your calibration standards. When you're all done, press Stop and auto-scale the plot. Hopefully the points line up nice and straight. If not, something went wrong and you may have to prepare your standards again, or maybe there were air bubbles in your cuvettes. If there is a line joining the points, get rid of it in graph options by checking off connect points and checking on point protectors. Now, let's get a best fit line by pressing the button in the menu bar. Brilliant. Check out the box and notice that it has all the info you need. Next you need to measure your unknown sample. Stick it in the spec and record the absorbance in your notebook. You don't know its concentration, so don't worry about trying to keep it, you just need the absorbance. That's it. Now all you have to do is use your data to find the concentration of your unknown. That's a snap, right? Time to clean up. Now you know how to create a calibration curve using a Vernier spectrophotometer.